हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डील विद अ पोएम आई रिमेंबर दैट इज़ कंपोज बाय थॉमस हुड. सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द पोएम वी शुड ऑल्सो नो समथिंग अबाउट द पोएट. आई मीन समथिंग अबाउट थॉमस हुड. हु इज़ थॉमस हुड? सो थॉमस हुड वॉज अ ब्रिटिश पोएट एंड राइटर ऑफ ह्यूमरस प्रोज ऑफ द अर्ली 19th सेंचुरी. He started his career by writing articles for various newspapers and magazines and later became the editor of a magazine. Hood also started a magazine in his own name to which he was the sole contributor, although Hood is remembered for his writings. He was a talented engraver and illustrated several of his own works. Thomas Hood was a British poet and journalist and humorist, and he was best known for his poems such as The Bridges of Sighs and The Song of the Shirt. Means these are his best known poems. So let's begin with the first stanza of this poem. I remember the house where I was born, the little window where the sun came peeping in at morn. He never came a wink too soon nor brought too long a day. But now I often wish the night had borne my breath away. So in the first stanza, the poet is actually in the whole poem, the poet is recalling his past. And he is in the first stanza, he is remembering his house where he was born. And in the house, there was a little window through which the morning sunlight entered with a quiet sound in his house. So in the next line, he never came a wink too soon nor brought too long a day. So in these two lines, first line, that is he is used for sun, so he is personified here. He never came a wink too soon, that means that the sun always on time, it never came late. And the poet also says that the day was not too long, as the poet used to play whole day and it seemed to him that it was not the long day. Okay. But now I often wish the night had borne my breath away. But now in the present time, when the poet has become older, he wished to not wake up. Means the poet desired to live no more. Now come to the next stanza. I remember the roses red and white, the violets and the lily cups. Those flowers made of light, the lilacs where the robin built, and where my brother said the laburnum on his birthday, the tree is living yet. So in this stanza, the poet is describing about his garden that is full of beautiful flowers such as red and white roses, the violets and the lily cups. And those flowers looked extremely beautiful. And further, the poet says that on the lilacs is a small tree with having purple or white flowers over it. Okay. The robin built his nest, means on the lilac tree, the robin means a small bird. Okay. So robin built his nest on the lilac tree, and the same place means at the laburnum tree, on the lilac tree, the same place his brother planted a laburnum tree. Laburnum is a small tree which has hanging bunches of yellow flowers. Okay, so his brother planted a tree that is called laburnum at the same place on his birthday, and that tree is still present there, but his brother is no more. Now moving towards the next stanza. I remember where I was used to swing and thought the air must rush as fresh to swallow on the wing. My spirit flew in the feathers then that is so heavy now. And summer pools could hardly cool the fever on my brow. Further, the poet says that I remember means he is remembering when he used to swing, means there was a swing in his garden and he used to swing on there and he used to swing so high and would wish that air would take him so high just as the swallow. Swallow actually here means a small bird that fly very high and without any care, means carefree. It flies carefree. My spirit flew in feather then that is so heavy now. So the poet says that as a small child, his spirit felt joyous at the smallest of things. Means he gathered happiness from every smallest thing, like swing, the air, swallows, carefree flying, flowers, sun, sunlight. Everything made him very joyous. But now, at the present time, the poet is saying that is so heavy now, that all these things had gone away and he is feeling very heavy because he have lots of burden on his shoulder. So it is so heavy for him. And summer pools could hardly cool the fever on my brow. And the summer pools that keep him very cool, but it seemed to him that it is not giving him coolness. Okay, the fever on my brow, that his head is full of fever, it means it is warm due to lots of tensions. Okay, now move to the next stanza, that is last one. I remember the fir trees dark and high. I used to think their slender tops were close against the sky. It was a childish ignorance. But now, 'tis little joy to know that I farther off from heaven than I was a boy. Further, he is talking about the fir, it means tall trees. Tall trees, dark and high. Because of its tallness, the scene is look very dark. Okay, I used to think their slender tops, and he used to think about their slender, it means delicate and very high tops, that is of tree, were close against the sky, and it seemed to him that the tops of the tree touching the sky. Okay, it was a childish ignorance, and he was thinking that the top of the tree is touching the sky. So it was his childish ignorance. But now it is little joy to know that I am farther off from heaven, and it seemed to him that the heaven is, at that time he was thinking that the heaven is very near from the tree. Okay, to know that I am farther off from heaven, but now he know very well that the heaven is very far away. Then when I was a boy, it means when he was a boy, he was thinking that the heaven is very close to the tree, but it was not true. So as he grew older, so he became he come to know that the heaven is very far away from him. So this is all about the poem I remember.